And welcome everybody here in Twitch chat and everybody on YouTube for some Bannerman Vi. We haven't played a Vanguard Bannerman deck in a long time. And so we're playing these different Allegiance cards today. And so it's a good time to bring back a Vanguard Bannerman deck. Really, since the introduction of Grand Plaza, I think that's kind of hurt Vanguard Bannerman. Because a lot of the times with Demacia, you really wanted to play Grand Plaza. And if you're playing Grand Plaza on turn three, you don't really want to follow up Grand Plaza with Vanguard Bannerman because Plaza's not an ally to get the +1/+1, right? Like, you want to be able to play allies on, like, the first three turns and then play Bannerman. And so Plaza really rewarded you for playing Grizzled Ranger. Like, that was a great combination. So we're going to move away from Plaza. We're going to try Bannerman. I'm going back to some challengers, though. Lots of Ballistic Bots and Aphelios and Eye of the Dragon and things like that around. And so I think the challengers are pretty good these days. So we have Fiora and Laurent Protégé. We got War Chefs is back. So that's the thing with, like, War Chefs being a 2-2 again now. And it's playable. That also helps out Bannerman a bunch. So we got War Chefs to go along with Bannerman. These are both ways that we can, both War Chefs and Bannerman are ways that we can pump up Protégé to be 3 power, which, as we know, the 3 power is the necessary amount of power for a challenger. And same with the Fleet Feather Tracker. Besides that, the only non-Demacia card that we're playing in here is going to be Vi. I think Vi is another really good challenger. And so we're going to try Vi and Screeching Dragon in the 5 mana slot. So that's going to be our PNZ card that we're splashing here. Got some spicy tricks. We got, like, a back-to-back to surprise people. You know, one Prismatic Barrier whenever we need that. Some Ranger's Resolves, if those help out. And then a Judgment, because basically, we'll see how it goes. Like, a lot of these Aphelios decks and everything, like, they're going, like, people are going real wide right now with a bunch of small units. And so I feel like a Judgment plus Fiora could get us a surprise kill. Or even Judgment plus Vi is pretty awesome both ways. If you put a Judgment on a Vi and strike a bunch of things, you're going to strike for +10 damage, so you'll level up Vi. Or if you already have a leveled up Vi, this is pretty rare. This is hard to do, but it's possible. Like, let's say we have a leveled up Vi, and we're attacking. And we attack with, like, 3 units plus a Vi and Vi challenge, whatever. And they block with, like, you know, 3 things. Then we can cast the Judgment. And while we're attacking, instead of while we're defending, usually you play Judgment whenever you're defending. But if we have the leveled up Vi and we do it while we're attacking, then it's striking different units while you're attacking. So if it strikes, like, 4 things with a Judgment while it's attacking, each time it strikes something, that's 5 damage to the enemy Nexus. So you can get, like, a one-shot kill with Judgment leveled up Vi attacking. It's really hard to pull off. I'm not expecting that to happen. But I'm just saying that that's something that could theoretically happen. And then we also got the Bright Steel Formation at the top end, because that card is pretty cool. All right, so that's our deck. Let's try out Bannerman Vi. And there's Aphelios' Fate. Twisted Aphelios. All right, let's try to get a better curve out. With these decks, you want to really curve out with your units. You know, like 1, 2, 3. And so, like, the spells are good, but they're kind of interchangeable as well. And so I'm definitely glad we mulliganed 2 spells, because as you see, we've drawn 3 more. And glad we mulliganed the Screeching Dragon, because it came back anyway. So if I play War Chefs and they go Box to Bust Challenge, is that something I mind? Or maybe I should just pass and then play War Chefs on this turn.
Smell that? A bite to cook it.
So I'm attacking for 7. Or I make them waste their turn. I should probably just attack for 7.
Head to the face. Can't fight on an empty stomach.
I don't think we can play the make them waste their turn game against this deck and let them have all that mana. Wow, we got the best of both worlds. They pass their turn anyway. And so Ranger's Resolve is perfect against red card, if their plan is red card.
Never lost a fair game or played one.
Which it looks like it is.
Something for all of you.
This would have been a great turn to have a Bannerman. Like, imagine if, like, one of these four cards was Vanguard Bannerman also. That would have been pretty sweet. So should I play Screeching Dragon? What's the worst thing that can happen if I play Screeching Dragon? I mean, I guess I could play Protégé instead of Screeching Dragon. No, I mean, I think we can just play this. Because what are they going to do? Play another blocker? Well, we kill blockers. The thing about playing Protégé is I'd have three spells. With playing Dragon, I only get two. I only get Ranger's Resolve plus one of these two. And go, like, you know, maybe they have, like, Moon Weapon Stun, but... They have eight cards in hand. I only have four cards in hand, but four cards in play as well. So I either do this and go to four, or do this and try putting them down to two. Could have tried for lethal with the sharp sight, but I just don't really think that that would have happened. Hush, guiding touch, star shaping. Lots of ways for them to stay alive.
I'm always up for a round or two. Soak it in.
If I would have cast single combat in response, it would have gave them the opportunity to play something and free up their spell mana and then be able to play something else. Alright, just get out of here. And there we go. And same matchup again. I can tell you right now that this is going to be more difficult to win this one than it was the last time. They're going to have a better hand than what they had last time, because they did nothing last time. Now, I don't have something on turn one or turn two, but I do like the whole Fiora into Bannerman protector for the Fiora. Save our... You know, basically we're just... You know, right now we're just a Fiora deck. Just protect Fiora.
Save your worlds. We speak with blades.
Okay.
The brighter my light, the stronger your shadow.
So they threw an Aphelios in front of Fiora. Bold strategy. So that will... their Aphelios, though, even though they did, like, their Aphelios did take up my... I guess it doesn't really matter which one. It did take up, like, two sharp sights. It doesn't really matter. Like, they both do the same thing, right? Like, they both kind of die to... My opponent having... Okay, wait. So they are... Okay, so they're not a Mystic Shot deck, right? This is not PNC. So basically it's Hush. So, like, they... Both cards aren't great against Hush. But I might as well play this one, the cheaper one. Oh, Pale Cascade. Or that, they go grab my sharp sight. Okay, so yeah, I should have used Riposte. Okay, my bad. Yep, I didn't. Yeah, so should have used Riposte. I was just thinking of just Hush. Nope, stop. There we go.
Thank you.
Well, that's... You know, I wish I could go back in time. But you can't.
I'm still good to scrap!
Got your back!
I'm always up for a round or two.
That does still kill my Fleet Feather Tracker.
Something for all of you.
Who does not know the name LoR?
Oh, come on. They have the third?
But his knee out!
Just have all three?
Where are you off to?
Come on.
My wind streak!
Well, this looks bad. I just need to use that riposte.
Soldiers, to me.
Mess this game up.
Keep up.
Man, I'm gonna mess this game up. Wish we could go back in time.
Show them our mess.
Yeah, this looks pretty over now. I'm run out. That was rough. All three Boxtopus. Yeah, I don't know why I was so focused on Hush. I don't know. All three Twisted Fates. Is that the third? Or no, was I guess maybe the first Twisted Fate was that last game? Maybe that, I guess that was probably last game. Probably their second Twisted Fate. Thank you kindly, Juan. Thanks for that. Thanks for the sub. So yeah, I wish I would have seen what that game would have looked like if I would have used riposte. But I did not. Alright, definitely mulliganing that. This is a good Screeching Dragon matchup, but I think that we need to just kind of try to curve out better. And, you know, like, they are a Freljord deck. I don't want to hold on to the single combat. And then they just, like, frostbite my stuff. Okay, no Teemo is good. Where's our Warshafts? One turn two Warshafts.
Oh, yep. If mushrooms could talk.
I'll just hold on to these spells. I don't need to use all of them right now. I'm just gonna hold on to them.
Throw me mask, secure me tail, start the day.
Alright, Vi or Dragon. The good part about our deck is we don't really draw very many cards. All right, I got two pump spells.
A chill in the air. I
demand satisfaction. Eat this.
Hardly fair.
So they use another frostbite card on the Vi. We can buff it up to three again. That only makes it four. Alright, just gonna let the seven. I don't really want a single combat. Like, my choice here, I was thinking about single combating these two, the dragon and the pup cat paddler, but I don't want to do that and then get frostbitten. So now they just have one card in hand, so now I can. And then it kills my dragon. I like having units out for Bannerman. And of course, the fun part is leveled up by. Yeah! All right, cool. Good win. Two and one. Alright, back to Twist of Fate, Aphelios. Alright, War Chefs, Fiora, then Vi, and then. So I like those. Basically, am I keeping single combat? I think I'll keep War Chefs, Fiora, Vi. The single combat's the one I'm not sure about. And I think that answer, I think that's actually a no. I'm not sure. Okay, so that's going to be a riposte. We saw that last game. I needed to cast more riposte. So people in chat are talking about old Heimerdinger, how three mana for Heimerdinger used to make the 3-1 elusives. And Kordek goes, Riot, be like, those 3-1 elusives too oppressive. Let's print some Burble Fishes. Yeah, it's basically the same thing. Zero mana, 3-1 elusives around turn 6. You know, just like you would get with Heimer plus Flash of Brilliance. But now you just have to, like, play interaction and, you know, just play all, like, normal good cards, and then you just get 0 mana, 3-1 elusives.
Sunlight guide you, my brethren. They would fall by my blade.
So if I play Protege, they play Twist of Fate Gold Card. I can just simply attack, but that's only just killing like a Priestess and not really getting very good Fiora value. I could go Protector, they go Gold Card, it doesn't do any damage to Fiora. I think I'll play this. If they have like 6 mana Obliterate, if they got that with Priestess, then, you know, now we have like get a free Protege kill.
Feel the sizzle!
Oh god!
No one goes hungry!
Faith. be a good hand for Bannerman with all these units. Because really, all we have are units. You know, like, this is just a Fiora's Repose, but that's just a Fiora.
Never lost a fair game. Or played one.
Or even played one.
All that glitters.
You're covered.
I don't know. Feel like playing that. And then we'll play Tracker Warchefs. Now to two.
Honor guide me.
Positive fam. Eat up, friend.
I'm gonna try putting them to zero instead of putting them to two. This doesn't kill Twisted Fate, but puts them to zero. Boom. House LoR. Alright. Aphelios deck number four. Fourth Aphelios Bilgewater deck. But the other three had Twisted Fate. This one now has Diana. Okay, we got a mulligan. We may have to just mulligan all of these. Maybe I can't keep a five if we don't have anything cheaper. Yeah, probably do have to just mulligan them all. Man, I like Sharp Sight a lot. I'm going to keep Sharp Sight. Okay.
They forced us to choose death or the blade. Lunari, rise!
So even if we lose this, we're going to have a winning record of 3-2. And so we'll have all of our decks be 3-2. Nice 60% win rate. And 2 days ago, and none of these are Targon decks. 2 days ago, we had No Targon Tuesday, where I played No Targon decks, and we went 3-2 with all four of those decks. So this would be seven straight No Targon decks, where we're going 3-2. Like two days, Tuesday and Thursday, both of these days, I'm playing No Targon cards. I guess I nabbed some Targon cards. Oh, I should have just saved Sharp Sight, because obviously they're going to get the 2-drop. So I should save Sharp Sight. Because they go get the 2-drop, and then I Sharp Sight my 2-2. But yeah, so I think, because I think the small amount of removal... Wow. They grabbed that, and not... That's interesting. They didn't grab Boxtopus?
No more hiding.
Why would they not get Boxtopus?
I'll close my eyes, make it fair.
We will be free.
Blessings of the moon.
Okay.
Who does not know the name LoR?
So playing the Protege allows me to have these spells, specifically Sharp Sight, available. So that was the Aphelios champion spell. So they'll get a moon weapon, which after they cast it, they get another moon weapon. Because that'll be two spells.
So
unfortunately, they're going to just have a whole lot of moon weapons.
A
So now, since they didn't play it, now they don't get a Moon Weapon, because they don't have a Aphelios in play anymore. So it was a Aphelios champion spell too, right? Yes, it was. So now they grab Octopus, which what they should have done on turn two. But now they don't get another Moon Weapon. Oh, one mana short from that.
Ours is the one true light.
I'm not sure if this is a good spot to play. If I should, you know, like which one of these two I should be playing. If I should be playing Bannerman now. Bannerman just makes like the protege a 3/3. I guess I do that. Like, it's either play, you know, play that or play the Screeching Dragon. I guess we go Bannerman. One thing I've kind of noticed is that I haven't really liked single combat in this matchup, though. Like, the challengers have all been, like, really good, but, like, sometimes, like, we just have, like, too many of these single combats that I actually don't really want to use. Moon Weapon Boxtopus, pretty broken.
Calm mind and open heart greet the night.
So we're not looking in the best spot. This is kind of looking like how we lost the other game. Looks like my opponent's, like, you know, they've stabilized. We didn't have that many early units. We had too many of these single combats. All they have to do is just keep on playing bodies and invoking, and that'll be a wrap. From here, we kind of need, like, I don't know, like Fiora or just something pretty powerful, like a, you know, Bright Seal Protector, Fiora, Vi. Barrier. I mean, barrier makes my single combat better, I guess. Already kind of had that with the protector.
I've got your back.
What was that card that we played? I don't even remember what it was. All these games against Aphelios have all been just kind of the same. I don't remember what spell we played this game. I don't think it was Sharpsight. Even though we played tons of Sharpsights, but I don't think that's what we played.
Embrace the light.
Maybe it was. Actually, it was Sharpsight. Yeah, it was. Okay, yeah, it was Sharpsight.
No lies. I will be heard.
Punish transgressions.
Because, yeah, we cast the sharp side on the protege to kill Aphelios earlier. Rude.
Ah!
course, they're back to 20.
Strength in grace, beauty in the blade.
Not good for me.
Bless the faithful and sear the heretics.
Okay, so we know they have a sharp sight. I got pass. I could just trade, but considering we have cards like Bright Steel Formation and this is gonna be annoying. Bright Steel Formation, Vanguard, Bannerman, that kind of stuff. I don't think that we're supposed to just trade, and I want them to have the smaller units for us to challenge anyway. Well, I could technically use both of these to survive. Like, if Warrior challenges Fiora and has Sharp Sight, I can use both of those to survive, but... The Aphelios ran me out of cards. You know, just... Aphelios create Moon Weapon to shoot your War Chefs. Aphelios create Moon Weapon to go grab Octopus. That, you know, kills a protege and then also sticks around. Priestess create this thing. Fangs create some stuff.
Hey, right, where are you off to?
By my spear. Dear mortal.
Okay. So assuming they have Sharp Sight, I have to use the back-to-back on the Fiora, and therefore I can't save Protégé. Assume they want to go Sharp Sight on that, so I go back-to-back on, like, these two. I guess I could just do it on my two challengers. That'll keep their 5-2 alive. Like, he'll keep this warrior alive as a 5-2. But then, so I'll just have to have my protege challenge the warrior. But then they can save it then from Sharp Sight. They'd be able to save it with Sharp Sight either way. They drew fleeting cards this turn. I don't know how many fleeting cards they have left, and so maybe they're thinking if they cast a Sharp Sight, they don't get to play a fleeting card that they want to. But they may cast a Sharp Sight on the snake to try to kill Protégé that way. Yep, so there's the Sharp Sight on the snake. And I hope at least one of these should be fleeting, right? At least this one? I hope they both are. That'd be great if they're both fleeting. But I think the one on the right is, at least.
Press on.
I could be wrong. Yeah, I'm not sure. Yep, it was. And it was Spell Cascade.
Piltover Enforcer on the scene. Keep up, keep up.
You call this a fight? Aha!
Trouble coming at ya.
Awesome.
Too easy. Try again.
Come on, Bright Steel Formation. For us.
Night flowers upon my blade.
Okay, so that's some... What's that spell? Oh, Gifts from Beyond. That's such a great spell. Now they just go grab Octopus.
I'm still good to scrap.
Alright, we need to draw something like a barrier, riposte. Single combat. What is that going to do for me?
Temperamental as
moonlight. Not much. Oh, come on, really? So they're... Their last two draws were to Sprayfin into, you know, Moon Weapon, and then Aphelios into Moon Weapon. That's their two draws. Oh, I didn't notice that thing was going to level up. Now I can't fight and kill it. So I wanted them to attack and everything, and then during combat I was going to, you know, have Vi fight the Aphelios and kill it. I should have paid attention to, like, this thing leveling up. Yeah, because I just can't kill this Boxtopus. Well, I could have Fiora fight Aphelios now. Maybe that's what I need to do.
Do not waver.
There's the 1-2 punch. Move it.
Yeah, it's a difficult game. At least they grabbed the wrong moon weapon, right? Because they grabbed the moon weapon to get a 2-drop. They don't even have any 2-drop left in their deck. So they would have just got, like, literally any other 2-drop. They would have been in a lot better spot. Come on, something sweet. No, Riposte, why couldn't I have you last turn? Oh, if that was just traded, that could have saved the Fiora. Gross. No, we're not playing any kind of card draw or anything. No, we're just trying to curve out and win, and my opponent just, you know, stabilized this time and we didn't able to have it. But as you can see, we have been very successful against these Aphelios decks before, but they had a very good hand of the turn 3 Aphelios plus moon weapon, and then, you know, another moon weapon on 4, and another Aphelios and moon weapon on 5. So we just, you know, that's difficult to deal with, but. Okay, what's up, Fiora? I think they may be out of Aphelios.
Find your path in the dark.
I think.
And follow no false light.
Yeah, they do seem a little scared.
No more lies. I will be heard. Counter and strike.
All right, one Fiora kill down. Right, steel formation. Considered strike's not bad. Two Fiora kills down. Of course, we're gonna need something to protect Fiora's health as far as challenging goes. Stop with these moon weapons. But they don't have any Boxtopus left. And it's like 3 damage to a follower, but I don't have any followers. And then overwhelm and lifesteal. Why do they keep on getting this? They don't have. Oh! They just put all those messengers in their deck. Oh. Well, that's pretty sweet. Alright, you got me.
Embrace the light.
Alright, you got me. Lunamas. No.
Sunlight blinds while moonlight reveals. Was that a glimmer of starlight I saw?
Down to 2.
Come on.
Okay, basically so many cards: Bright Steel Protector, Bright Steel Formation, Riposte, War Chefs, Prismatic Barrier, Concerted Strike. That won't do it. So many cards. No, I couldn't bluff there. I mean, that's an attack all out. I couldn't bluff. Because Yeah, so I have... That's true. Sharp Sight, so I could... That's true. I think that's probably my best play is Hope for Sharp Sight or Concerted Strike. And I think I might as well play this. But back-to-back draws of the one-drops. The weakest cards in the deck, the one-drops. Back-to-back draws. One mana, two ones. While they're over here casting a million moon... You know, like they're drawing all these million moon weapons and stuff. Alright, so... I could stay alive by challenging there, but then I'm just not winning the game. Right. Where if I... So, like, I could have challenged the 3-3 and stayed alive. But if I... By not making the challenge... But then, you know, it's like, how do I actually, like, really win the game against Targon? Like, I'm not really winning the game. But I think this gave me some outs. It gave me, like, Sharp Sight, which I should have a couple of. It gave me my last Concerted Strike, and it gave me Judgment. If they attack with other stuff also, you know, it gave me a Judgment out. So it basically gave me four cards as an out. And then, or... Yeah, then like single combat would have been a still stay alive kind of card.
It's our time.
Oh wow. Just the best life for my opponent though. So in conclusion, I think our deck actually looked really good. You know, this again was another 3-2. Not bad. We played against four Aphelios decks. We went 2-2. We had two pretty decisive wins. We had a loss where I made a big mistake of playing. I played Sharp Sight when I needed to play Riposte. I think that, you know, like if we play the Riposte on that turn four after the Fiora, maybe that's a win. Like that was a big mistake that cost me one game against the Aphelios deck. And then we had that last Aphelios deck where they had, you know, like turn three, Nightfall Aphelios plus Moon Weapon, like just the dream. And then also turn four, another Moon Weapon with the Aphelios Champion spell. And I kill the Aphelios on that turn four. Then turn five, they play a new Aphelios and get another Moon Weapon. And so then they had all of that. They went ahead. We actually, you know, got to the real late game where we were both in top deck mode. And at the end of the game in the top deck mode, you know, they just kept drawing more really good cards. And we kind of kept drawing Flea Feather Trackers. But it was really close. But, you know, like, so, like, I think that just overall I was really impressed with our deck. And I just impressed with Challengers. I think that that's a good way to fight Aphelios is Challengers. And so Protege, Fiora, Screeching Dragon, Vi, all four of those cards were really nice. Flea Feather Tracker did some good work, too. Didn't really draw these top end cards too much, like, you know, Judgment, Bright Steel Formation. Didn't have those. They would have both been really nice at any point in those games. But this was a nice solid deck, and I think it matches up pretty well against that Aphelios deck. All right, but that's it here for Bannerman Vi. So those of y'all watching later on YouTube, hit that like button over there. And of course, leave those comments as well. I would appreciate that. Let me know what you think of the deck and, you know, like how you like Challengers in this metagame. But that's all I got here for this one. So thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you for the next video.